Hello guys, I am back again, still updating you with the breaking trending news, what is going on in Nigeria. So good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, depending on your location at this time of the day. All right, guys, so far so good. I don't want to waste much of your time. I want to give you this breaking news. As we already know that PDP has elected Atiku Abubakar to be their flag bearer on the 2023 presidential election. So just after when Atiku was declared winner of that primaries, there was a lot of confusion in APC. Yes, because Atiku Abubakar is more like a Fulani man, and he is a northerner, okay? And we already know when these people talks about population that they have the population to win any election of their choice. So according to APC, they were lamenting who to choose, if it should be a northerner or a southerner. So far, so good. Just as you have seen on your screen, that Buhari has, shortlisted two aspirants as his successor. Remember a few days ago when Buhari told APC governors to help him to look for a successor, all right? And then, believe me, everybody already know that Tinubu is nowhere near that list, okay? People have speculated that Tinubu has been sidelined by Buhari, okay, by not keeping to his promise after 8 years that he will hand over to Tinubu. And then, that notwithstanding, that shouldn't be a surprise because we already know that these northern people knows how to play politics. At exactly time, they know what to do. And then people already know that Tinubu could in any way, nowhere to be found in that list. Irrespective of moving up and down, bribing people, going traveling to state, different state to consult, delegate. And so far, so good. According to APC, it is going to be a consensus because they know that if it should be an election, Tinubu have the money, just like what Atiku did, bribing delegate with $35,000. They know that Tinubu has the money and the highest bidder takes it all. Okay, so far so good. Let me not waste much of your time. The two persons Buhari has shortlisted to succeed him is Professor Yemi Osinbajo, and then the Senate President Ahmed Lawan. So a presidential source disclosed that Buhari is torn between the choice of Lawan and Osinbajo following the emergence of former President Atiku Abubakar of PDP. Just like what Ojuz Okalu said, that if APC do any slightest mistake, that PDP will win 2023 election since Atiku Abubakar has become their flag bearer. Okay, guys, let me know what you guys think about Ahmed Lawan. Remember, some Southeast delegate is supporting Ahmed Lawan. The likes of Ojuz Okalu supporting Ahmed Lawan. He's a northerner. So according to Ojuz Okalu, that Ahmed Lawan is from Northeast and they are suffering the same persecution, marginalization Southeast is suffering. So Ahmed Lawan is supporting Ojuz Okalu is supporting Ahmed Lawan. I think Imo State Governor Hopus Odima is also supporting Ahmed Lawan. And some Southeast leaders, they are supporting Yahaya Bello. But the question is, why is the Southeast not supporting their brothers? That is what we should be talking about in the next video. Their brothers are there. Peter Obi is there. This is one of the reasons why Peter Obi left for Labour Party. And as I am talking to you, there is every tension that Peter Obi may not emerge as the presidential candidate of Labour Party. I will give you the details of that particular story. But however, I quickly want to update you the two preferred candidates of Buhari in APC. All right, guys, see you in another update.